this is our mission brief. Engine started at 10 after takeoff at 7:50 and landing at 5:25. Telescope status.
It's ready. Ready to go.
Mission systems.
Good to go.
FVLS also measured this source, but obviously cannot resolve the structure in velocity. And this is a profile as great measures towards the center of this nebula. And you see the complex dynamics that is going on, these different shells and blobs evaporating or expanding from the central white dwarf.
For tonight, your safety techs, myself, John, and Juan. Our mission director tonight is Nancy. The doors are all closed and armed. If there's an emergency or whatever, we have to open the doors. The safety techs, the mission director are responsible for them.
Here we are, we're on this incredible flying telescope right now, and about 50 feet behind me is an instrument that's cryogenically frozen to 4 degrees above absolute zero, which is blowing my mind at the moment. And right behind that, back half of this airplane is wide open, and we've got this incredible device looking out into the middle of a galaxy far, far away. That's pretty cool.
As if you were behind the telescope looking out the door, the green thing in the center, that's the secondary mirror. There's three vanes holding up the secondary. The large circle is the primary. That's the secondary in the middle of the primary.
We're observing this one part of the galaxy, and this one part of the galaxy is where stars are born. Just like you're born and have a life cycle, stars do that as well, and it's happening all the time in the universe, and it tells us different things about the universe based on where they're
We look for signatures of certain elements like carbon or nitrogen or oxygen, and it tells us something. So we may not actually be able to see the stars forming, but we can detect that they're forming by looking for these signatures.
On this mission, we're looking for oxygen lines. Just the mere fact that we're breathing oxygen on land, that should be enough of a compelling story to help feel a connection to space.
Segments, so the pilot tweaks the heading by a degree at a time.
Yeah.
Nancy says, okay, we need another degree tweak. And upstairs they'd say, okay.
1 degree left.
Roger.
The plane is in turbulence and you feel like the telescope is wobbling up and down, but from your frame of reference, it's the telescope that is staying perfectly stationary on this ball bearing. And we're the ones that are in turbulence. It's just fascinating to me that we could be in the air observing an object in space, and we can actually keep the telescope steady enough to be able to observe it clearly and without wobble. It's like trying to look through binoculars at the back of your car.
It's great to see how this whole SOFIA structure works. It's a really intricate puzzle, and to see the pilots communicating with the mission directors, communicating with the scientists, and fine-tuning this whole process as we go.
Science isn't taught just in a silo, isn't just taught in chemistry class, or isn't just taught in physics class. Instead, science crosses over boundaries.
That interaction with the people who are doing the work, it's amazing.
I think about my students in career-wise. They might not all be scientists, but there might be some other careers that they can endeavor into because this is a whole support system here. You need the engineers. You need the technicians. It's a big team effort in order for the science to move forward.
The beauty of a program like NASA is that it can be very relatable. I hope that one of the things we're able to take away from SOFIA, bring back to our community, is that we can connect really young students, really old students, and everybody in between with the material.
It's beyond exciting. It's beyond fascinating. It's fantastic.